about roles and the characters that you've played over various different movies and television series that you've been very impactful. To actually talk about that and start with hear about your journey as an actor and what motivated you in taking up acting as a career.
Okay, so you want to just peep into my long past and come from there to the present?
A little about the past, because your personality brings on a lot of story than just the characters. So we would like to also
All the traits started from the school days. Okay, when there was some elocution competitions or mono act things. So those were the germs where you could know that, okay, you know, you can act, where you can get some applause from the audience, from your colleagues and all. And after the show, they used to say, yeah, Rajesh, you're acting well, yeah, good, yeah, achha gaya. So those were those very tiny moments of your life. So that was a part. Then cut to, if I come to my college, again, in the college year, and interviews and festivals, I used to take part. So there also, I used to get the appreciation, but never the thought sinked in, yeah, I would take it as a profession.
Uh-huh.
I always wanted to go in defense. I wanted to serve my mother by going, by joining those courses and wearing those uniforms.
Oh, and very impressive to hear.
And somewhere down the line, I got selected also for the Air Force pilot, okay?
Oh, wow.
It and all, and it was a very tough competition. It's a very competitive
SSB thing, yes.
Yes. So I got selected for that also. But then in the medicals, for the pilot, which is very essential, is the eyes. And they thought there is some substandard color vision, which I then countered it. But there they found, yes, you have. You couldn't predict the primary colors in 3 seconds. So there I got disappointed, because that's a very pivotal test for, you know, for any pilot.
It's, yeah.
So the whole thing just fell apart. It was like, I thought, okay, I'm just getting down. I didn't know what to do. So then, see how it happens. It's all a chain. It's everything is chained, you know. Your life is all chained. You just have to come across those moments. So when I got dejected, I was disappointed. I never wanted to go for that routine 9-to-6 job.
Right.
But somehow, I did it. Somehow I did it, because after college and doing my LLB, I thought, let's get occupied somewhere. So through a friend, I got a job in a very good firm. But there, my soul wasn't there.
Do it.
Same friend, he told me, ki Rajesh, there's this film coming up where my boss has told me, his boss was a retired army officer. Okay. That boss's friend was making a film. He was also a major, retired major, and he was with Raj Kapoor banner, RK Studio.
Right.
Person was directing. He must have told his boss, yaar, koi achhe ladke ho to bata, because I want to introduce some few good actors.
New talent.
New talent. So, vice versa, it came to me, some from him to him. And then I said, nahi yaar, apne ko kaha profession karna hai uspe. And where, I don't know, the RK Studio is such a big banner. Where, I don't know anybody, you know, you should go, we have seen your talent in colleges and all. So you should go. See, he had seen my work somewhere in college. He was a witness to all my acts and all. So he thought very strongly that I should go and at least meet that gentleman. But I was a little reluctant. I didn't go for a few days. Then he said something which triggered me. He said, you should go, yaar. Hum log jaise log, you should have, koi aur hota to, he would have gone, you know. You should make it a point to go and at least visit him. Somewhere some signals are there, you should catch it. I said, okay, fine. So I went and happened to meet the gentleman, and with my voice and with my, because I had done some NCC in college, National Cadet Corps. Yeah. I was All India Platoon Commander. That's another story. So I gave him a salute, civil salute, and the way I spoke to him, he just loved it.
Okay, and along with him, that's how Parambir Chakra, the movie, happened.
Yeah.
So, that was actually really living your other dream through an acting career, literally.
Yeah. Exactly. See, the first film only I did was Paramveer Chakra. I actually yes. wanted my whole life. Really? And then I got this film and I got this award also in that film. Posthumously. So my first check was given by Mrs. Raj Kapoor. So that was a very privileged project, but commercially it wasn't that viable. Okay. So that's how the journey started. Right. And then again, that connection which we were talking on the WhatsApp, that connection, just when I got rejected from the Air Force, I thought everything has gone now. Maybe I'll have to do the job and all. Because my heart was not falling in place for other things. So there, a professor of mine, he told me, Rajesh, you look so disappointed and all. Why don't you come and meet, come at my place? There's this Sadhguru whom I worship and I follow him. So you meet him. So I wasn't that keen, but because he was insisting, I went there. And today I am his much very big follower and I'm his disciple. So he had told me, this is your profession. There may be thousands and thousands of candidates coming for that role. You will be selected. So you don't worry. You are destined to get this only, this film line. So after six months of what he said, I got selected. After 6 months. So those 6 months were very difficult for me. I had to leave the job. I had to take a decision of whether quitting the job or to continue with this, without knowing anything. So yeah. Then Paramveer Chakra happened, and then the appreciation thing, then another film I did. So that's how I came in this line.
Yes. There is a certain connection between your personality, what aspirations which you had, because I think a lot of very prominent and strong roles you played had something to do with the defense, like you played a raw agent, you played a CIA agent, and you played a cop, and different roles you played, and you played protagonist roles, but mention roles that really had an impact on you, and you can learn from, some of the actors which were strong influence on you.
Especially the first film which I did, was very close to my heart, because that's how my journey started in this profession. The life of an army officer, which we know by reading something or going through projects, but actually living that character and going in the borders and shooting and encountering them, asking sharing some experiences with them. Yeah. So it's something mind-blowing. The way they see their life, the way they conduct themselves, the patriotism that they have for their motherland, and for them other issues are very minuscule. Nothing is for them than the valor that they fight for their country, to save their country. So that's very close to me.
Yes.
Then I played Bhagat Singh in one of the projects. While playing that character, while going through his autobiographies and his books, I was completely enamored by his character. And at the age of 21, 22, that was a very small age. I mean, this 2021 today's generation also.
Disillusioned, they don't know. And just imagine, he laid down his life at that age. Yeah.
So that fervor that he had for his country, the fervor that he had for his fellow beings, something. So that character I've taken inside my heart. Those are the few characters. Then, of course, when I am playing this current character, Mallarao Holkar, there are many other characters also. But those characters are appreciated, but those like the antagonists which I played, the gangsters which I played, or the characters which are against the system, I don't want to. But this Mallarao again, which I am playing, a very compassionate character.
Yes.
But he understands the person whom he's talking to, what he's going through, what made him speak those lines, what made him think on that line, why is he behaving like that. There must be some turmoil in his life. That's the reason why. So those things he could understand, and therefore he could fathom the fact that this little girl, Ahilya, is of a great substance. If you mold her properly, she can be a great boon to our country.
Absolutely.
So this character, currently, if you ask me, Mallarao is something that I'm taking it every day to my home,
Yeah.
It's all into my character, I'll be blessed.
talking about the mindsets that exist even in the 21st century, and we still see a lot of people who think that women are, not as efficient as men, or they don't deserve to be in certain places like men do. So there are societies that has evolved, and still there are certain mindsets that has not. But there's so much to learn from, from the character of Malhar Rao. What similarity do you see in the real Malhar Rao and the real Rajesh Shringarpure? What kind of similarities do you see that it's he and it's you and the same thing?
Yeah, playing a very good question, very subtle question, but there is something in it. There is something lying in this question. You know what? I'll love to answer this. Playing Malhar Rao, when I'm on the set with the costumes and with my overall getup, I don't consider myself that I'm playing a part. I consider myself that I am that part. There's a difference, very thin line between what I'm saying. No?
Yes.
If I'm trying to act what I want to act, then it becomes act. Then it becomes something that you are trying to portray something which you're not.
Right.
But I'm not trying to do that. I am trying to do that what I am.
Right.
In that costume, and with those lines given to me, and with that mood and the situation, that I have to enact something which I know I have to do because I am the one. It's not somebody else who is there. There is something. Are you trying to understand what I'm?
Yeah, absolutely. Yes.
This is very important to get into that character, to sink in that character.
Yes, but
many a time, I love to get into the character on the very first day, because this whole team is very new to me. This whole team, the director is completely new to me. I've never worked with him before. The production house, they know me as an actor, but we never got the chance to work with them. So on the very initial day, in the initial days before the shoot, I told him, he'll have to excuse me for the moods that I may have during the shoot, because I will consider myself as a king there. That aura I want to create. It couldn't be that I'll be sitting like what I normally sit, like Rajesh at home or somewhere with my friends. But in that costume and all, I'll try to be living that character for all those 12 hours of shoot. So you'll have to excuse me if I don't greet you all. Good mornings, good evening, hi, how are you? I may be in that character, absorbed in that character. It may sound a little more snobbish or whatever, but let me be in that character. It's something that I want to live this part. And they understood it. Because of my credentials of the past, they understood it. Yeah, that's the way he goes about. And maybe that's the reason why people have accepted it readily, they have received it.
Tell me something, as you play Malhar, as you portray Malhar with your character, and it is a historic character. Certain things that you think that today's society should not have Malhar Rao and imbibe, even in today. Some of the things you feel that, we should learn this and everyone should practice this, certain things.
The first and the foremost thing that everyone needs to learn is compassion. It's a very small word, but it covers up the entire humanity. Compassion. And never take anybody for granted. These are the two things Malhar Rao always had in him. The affection.
Right.
And the will to help others.
Right.
To go out of his way and help people around. And that's the reason why people used to love him. That's the reason why Peshwa gave him such a big title of Subedar, Sardar. He was a very common man. He was from Shepherd community.
Exactly. And he rose up to that level of excellence.
Peshwa had that faith in him that this gentleman will take care of the entire whole region mm-hmm. on his own, because he had that in him. He saw that in him.
The quality.
The humble background he came from, Shepherd community. But the desire, not only his the valor or the bravery that he had in him, his foresightedness, his vision. He was a visionary man. And he could foresee things that Ahilya, being a child of 9-year-old, she could, take things in her stride. She could easily, look after his region after he gets retired and all.
Yes.
So these are the things you should understand a human being, no matter if he is a family member or a layman. outsider or a stranger, he should be able to, if he's connected with him, he should be able to understand his emotions.
Right.
It's so beautiful. It's such a beautiful
because a lot of stories about Ahilya Malhar Rao Holkar was actually not taught in history. There were many history books which doesn't talk about them, and yet Ahilya Bai Holkar was a prominent name because airport in India is named after Ahilya Bai Holkar. The Ahilya Bai Holkar Airport. And still, a lot of mentions in the history books which could have been there is not there. So a lot of people with the non-Indian Indians or people so they would have known the people who empowered minds. So
yeah, that is one of the reasons why people are glued to this show, because they knew Ahilya, they knew Malhar Rao, but in glimpses. They knew in a very brief way their characteristics, what they have done for this country or for themselves.
Absolutely. Yeah. History books which never talked about them, literally never talked about. We have learned a lot about the Mughals, but not about the leaders strongly on the land of India. So it was not true.
To say, but the invaders were glorified more than the people who protected us.
Exactly. So that's a bit of sad, but also the fact is it's high time we learn, and high time. We spread the message of these lessons, because it's not history, it's actually contemporary lessons that we need to learn, because no matter how old they may sound, they are not. They are actually very empowering.
Very relevant, yes.
So they are very relevant, yes. So that's exactly why I think this is gaining so much of popularity even among people.
When I gone for this Indian Idol thing, I mentioned there. You see, there is a saying we all know, behind every successful man, there is a woman. But this saying came when women were confined to their household activities. They used to look after the community and only, you know, family. And men used to go out and do whatever he wished to do for his family or for himself. And he used to grow leaps and bounds. And women, because he used to take care of his family,
right,
and therefore that support was there. But in now today's generation, even women are at par, or maybe a little more ahead also, if you compare in some fields. So if a man is behind a woman, so women can also go leaps and bounds. She can. So, but this had already happened, 300 years back when Malhar Rao had supported Ahilya Bai. So this was all that a man had supported. So behind every successful woman, that's Ahilya, there was this man. Maybe his relationship was a father-in-law. But any man for that matter, any family, or the woman, may it be her father, may it be her brother, may it be a father-in-law or an uncle, if he is supporting that female, if she wants to do something in her life, she can score 100 out of 100.
Right, that's true. Like music and art, a very girlish thing, and you know, it's something that you follow, but he, the father-in-law, this person, Malhar Rao, he kind of encouraged the best of evolving behaviors and characteristics in both the son as well as the father-in-law. So whatever they are good at, he encouraged that. I am asking about this question because there are times, even in today's world, people kind of have these gender biases, you know, like this is what men are expected to do, that is what women are expected to do. Men cannot cry and women cannot do this. So do you think, I mean, of course, I'm sure you don't think this is something which is justified, but what ways do you think people can break out of this barrier, you know, broken mentality sooner? How do you think that will be? As an actor, you know, what are the ways that you impact these people around you also?
The United Nations has come up in 2015 with this Sustainable Development Goal, SDG, where it's for the awareness of the women to know their rights, you know, they know the policies that the government has made for them, the laws that they have made for them, the schemes that they have made for them. Most of the women in our country, if I'm talking about, are not aware of it. If those things are set right, na, then I don't think there will be this gender inequality or gender bias. So they're very nicely laid up things in this SDG by the United Nations for each and every country. Basic purpose is to have peace and prosperity and success all over, you know, attainment of mind. That's the whole idea behind it. And especially for women, that awareness is not there. That 100% education which is supposed to be there, right. It's not there.
Right.
You know, things come up, flare up in the society. I think many problems will be solved. Financially, she should be independent. That's what liberalization is all about. If she is independent financially, she can take her own decisions. Because she is subdued, because she is subjected to a place, she's not able to take those decisions. That's what I feel. That's what women empowerment is all about.
Right, absolutely true, very true. So, yes, there's a lot of inspiration in your character in Malhara, whole time that you played, and that has really inspired you, or your team that has actually had an impact on society in a good way.
Sorry, what was the point?
Well, just like Malhara Holkar's character, which is currently being aired and it's gaining so worldwide popularity because of its relevance, because of its, you know, the way it is impacting society. Name some of the other characters you played and how they impacted society, or you, or society as you see, even though they may be like even old, like, because you've been acting since 1995. You've been acting in regional Bollywood as well as Hollywood. So name any character which you think has had such impact on society or the audience.
I don't know about whether they impacted the society, but they have impacted me a lot as an individual. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes. Malhara Rao, for 100% it has impacted the society. They are loving this USP quotient of a father-in-law helping out his daughter-in-law in all ways.
Yes.
He's like a strong pillar for her. Come what may. Yes. May it be against his wives, maybe it against his son, maybe it against the whole patriarchal norms. He is behind her.
Right.
That's such a lovely thought. Huh?
Such a wonderful.
And that's what we're all talking about, you know. A small child, she's doing something on her own, she wants to do something and nobody's supporting her. Not even her parents, nobody. But then this gentleman comes from somewhere and he finds something that spark in her and he's feels inside ki ye ladki ko main bachaunga, ye ladki ko main le jaunga aur isko ek banaunga, ek rani banaunga. Against going against all his wives and against all the people. Such a lovely, just loving, I'm in love with this character. You just can't take this character out of me now.
It's amazingly high, because you know, even for, I can see amongst you know, my friends circle, you know, even for those who saw the basic promo that came out that this conversation is coming up soon with Rajesh Ringarpure, who's playing Malhara. So everyone is like, wow, he's coming, and you know, please tell him that, you know, he is so amazing in this show and this and that. And you should
all of your friends.
They are thrilled, and these are the people who are busy professionals. You know, you will be amazed to know that they hardly watch anything but cricket or something, which is like, you know, some seasons of something, glued in front of television to watch your show at 6 o'clock our time, which is just from work, and like come back fast and sit in front of the volume up because we want to focus on the show. Good. And I'm not exaggerating. This is the reality. And it's not happening in one or two places. It's happening in many places. And we are not even in India. No, we are far away. We are watching a day later, actually. And we are still like...
A lovely message that came to me from Saudi Arabia, a woman. What a fantastic message it was. I want to share with you.
Sure.
She said, Rajesh ji, you must be having a lot of fans across the world because of the show and people are loving it and blah, blah, blah. But there's a very tiny fan of yours, and I'm very मैं बिल्कुल क्या she said something in Hindi. मैं confirm हूँ कि ये सबसे आपकी छोटी fan है. मैंने कहा कैसे? तो वो she's just a year and a half old, and because she started newly walking and running all over, it becomes difficult for me to feed her. Okay, so that's the reason why we start playing this Ahilya show, because she loves the show. The moment she hears your voice.
Yes.
She stands still. She's just rooted there on that particular place. She then slowly comes and watches you and your voice, and it becomes very easier for me to feel.
I'm surprised. I'll tell you why. My son is 3-year-old and he does the same. It's not like I have difficulty feeding him, but he's like, Ahilya, Ahilya, Ahilya. So he's like that, you know, and he's going to watch this show. And every time you appear, he doesn't yet know that Ahilya is the name of a girl. So he will see you and he'll say, Ahilya. So he saw the promotion poster which I had. He said, Ahilya. I said, Ahilya. He's my father. He's like, Ahilya, Ahilya. No, so imagine 1.5-year-old child, 3-year-old kid, you know, and the impact. You know, that is the all. And I'm sure that people should learn from this, you know.
Come, most of them are all children of below 15-year-old, and they all call me Pakkam Pakka Dost.
Right, right.
Yeah. Feel that I am their Pakkam Pakka Dost. They relate with them. My character.
And one thing I really like about the character Malhar Rao, and I was actually telling this one, men should learn that this is what makes them really masculine and attractive, is that you're brave, you're strong, but you're kind and compassionate. Just think that balance is what men
rightly said,
respected. You know, but you get what I'm.
Yeah, yeah, that's a very unique combination of a man.
Yes.
He's brave, he's strong, but at the same time, he's kind, he's affectionate.
Yes, and you know the character of Malhar Rao. Why I really wanted to discuss the character of Malhar Rao with you, because you are not only playing it, but you are actually carrying it on your shoulders so well. Because people should learn. And when I say people, men, women, both, because these are characteristic qualities which one should understand. A lot of people think that, you know, when you're strong and when you're powerful, you turn out to be rude and very arrogant, which is wrong. And if you're very kind and compassionate, that is weakness. That is wrong. You know, so
ped jitna bada hota hai, vriksh jitna bada hota hai, utna hi wo jhuka hua hota hai.
Exactly. Exactly. Oh, I'm loving this conversation with you, because you're actually, you know, teaching so much. It should really impact minds. You know, there are people across places who should listen. You're not just an actor. You're a motivational speaker. We should just talk about your role, and this will really tell people how to learn to behave. A lot of people should learn that.
I am of the firm belief that as an actor, whatever roles are coming my way, those were all, how do I put it? Those were all my characters, you know. Those were destined that I would only get it. Like Paramvir Chakra, as I told you my back history, that I wanted to go in the forces, but God said, ki, yaar, had you been to forces, you may not have got the Paramvir Chakra, the highest gallantry award. You may not have got it in real life, but I'll give you in real life the highest gallantry award. Why are you worrying, my son? And I'll give you a profession which you would love, because you have loved right from your school days. So just have patience, hold your horses. I'll give you a good profession. And that's right. How it happened.
Right.
I met my Sadhguru. He directed me nicely. I had a very bad phase in my life and career-wise. You know, things were not moving because I was getting appreciated from all corners. Right from Mr. Bachchan to Dharmendra to Jitendra to everyone, they used to appreciate in all my films what I've worked with them. But that spring moment, that going immediately after that, was not happening. It was very slow and slow. I was being frustrated at that point. So then Sadhguru calmed me down. He said, see, everything has its own time. Yes. Don't worry.
Yes.
You just be very clear with your conscience. Don't do something which will hamper your mindset and which will hamper your own self. And then you will feel guilty. Maybe others may not find it. Yeah, Rajesh Vacha, but you know that you have done something wrong. So that thing also should not happen with you. If that happens, then something will falter. Something which has to happen may not happen. But in those growing days, something or the other, we, as a human being, we tend to do something, you know. We err, you know, human is to err, right? So, but now, I mean, yes, it takes time for any individual.
Right.
For me, it must have taken a long time to get noticed. But I'm still hopeful. And someday,
you know,
yes.
It sure will happen, you know, because even like as we are interacting now, you know, I'm saying this because I have seen so many of your films, and yet it took us a while to notice you, because now here's another compliment, because your face is so makeup friendly. I mean, the moment you cut your hair and shave, you're like, you're a completely different person. And then you, you know, grow your hair and a little bit of beard and, you know, your little curls and all. You're a completely different person. And then you put your mustache and some other different hairstyle and little white streaks, a completely different person. So later, when I noticed, oh my God, I've seen him in this movie, and every other movie, you know, and I never knew he's the same person. And I'm talking about one of my team members. Now, he's an American. He was watching pictures and he's like, this cannot be the same person.
Yeah.
Yes. You know, so that is why I think people, they think they're seeing casting directors and everyone else should actually see you. This is one man in all these plethora of looks.
Yes, yes.
You have sunk into the skin of every character and played them in such city that we really never realized that the same person. And I'm being honest, I'm telling you, I've seen Murder 3, Sarkar Raj, Steel 6, which I of course knew it was you. Then Romeo Akbar Walter, and there were some other movies also. I'm probably, you had a different look at you.
Yes.
How would we know it is you? I mean, so it's a compliment, but it's probably you blended in the role so well because. Other characters, you know, some very good actors, you know, when they come on screen, they have a certain aspect of them coming. Mr. Bachchan, he's so good. Comes and he brings in a bit of Bachchan in everything. It's like that. But you sink into the world.
Thank you, Stephanie. Such a lovely compliment.
Seriously, I'm telling you, because it's, I don't know if it was truly a compliment, just telling you the truth, because someone might not like to hear that, you know, I didn't get noticed that I blended all the time.
This is one of the best compliments an actor can get. And this I have received from some of my directors also, from a director or some other friends from this fraternity. Hey, Rajesh, when we see you in that character, it's like you are the character. It's not Rajesh Shingarpuri that we are watching.
Exactly.
Now, the film, the gangster flick, it was on real characters, okay? In late 80s and early 90s, there was this gang wars happening all over Mumbai. If you're aware.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, everyone was aware.
Not the dreaded the gangsters was Arun Dawli.
Daddy.
His part was Daddy Arjun Rampal played, and his guru in that field of gangsters was Rama Naik, which I played. So one critic, he said ki, of all the gangster flicks I have seen, Rajesh's character when he was portraying on the screen, it was one of the best performance of a gangster that I ever watched on screen.
It was like that hair and that thing, you know, no one recognized you. It was like as if some real gangster is sitting there and somehow you keep blending all along. How do you manage that?
You know? I love to get, as I told you, I just love acting. Because I have been a very observant man all my life. I speak very less. This is the first time whenever I give interviews, I normally talk. Otherwise, I'm very confined to my own self. I love observing people more. That's from my school days. As a child also, my parents used to tell me, why are you not talking to the guests, the visitors? You're just keeping yourself aloof, cut off. You're not talking to them. But I used to love watching them interacting with family members, fellow beings. In school also, I used to watch. So that's helped me to know many human characters and human traits, you know.
Okay.
That's helping me out as an actor, because I have seen so many, we all get to see so many people all around. But them is an art, and I feel that art has come in me right from my earlier days. To change my body structure also. It's not only the get up and all. My body structure, if suppose an actor or a director wants me to have six packs, so I make it a point to give him six packs in 2-3 months, because we know our body type, we know our constitution, body constitution. I know what has to be put in, what has to be not eaten. So that's how, you know, that becomes easier for me.
Discipline too. So yes, so much to learn from you actually in that game.
Whatever role comes to me, it should be a meteor role. It should be a good role where I should be convinced enough that I can play this part. And come what may, any character which comes my way, I should be able to convince the audience that this is the character. This is not the actor. This is that character that they have seen. This is what they are taking home. You know, if that's somewhere people get attached to, I think I am... मैं सही जगह पे अपनी रोटी खा रहा
हूँ. Give us some message for the society, for your audience, for your fans. I really want people to imbibe and follow and learn. Some message from you to your fans, to your audience and the society. Want them to imbibe, to learn and follow and emulate.
The key to anything is to have patience and to have the knowledge around what you're trying to do and have faith in yourself and have faith in someone whom you can rely blindly on. These are very small things, but this is what our culture is all about. And if these things have fallen in place, these things, if you have safeguarded them, come what may, there could be calamities in your life. There could be calamities all over the world. But one day you will outshine everyone.
Right.
Simple thought. But that faith, you have to repose in yourself. That yes, if I have now, it's as an actor, if I tell you about myself, there have been very difficult moments where there was no work at a point of time. And that work, no work was for countless months. So there was nothing, and there's no surety. No? This is not something like a provident fund. If you're there working for so many months and years, after this many years, you'll get matured and you'll get so much, such and such benefits. You have to hold your horses. You have to have that trust in yourself. This is, I think, the message, best message. And be compassionate, be loyal and sincere to yourself.
That's true.
Other may feel that you are good at heart and all, but you know what sins you have done inside. So that also should not be there. You should be a pure soul. What you were as born as a pure soul, that pure soul has to be there within you. You should feel that your soul is pure and dignified and classy. If that is there within you, you feel it, then everything becomes so rosy and so good. For all, the whole environment becomes so lovely.
You come across as a very spiritual person.
Yes, I am.
Yes, you are. You are a very spiritual person. And maybe you're not very ritualistic. Am I right? You're not very ritualistic maybe, but you're very spiritual. You know, you...
Yes, I am. I think I connect with the souls. If I am connecting with Mallara, I'm connecting with his soul. I'm not connecting with his... I've not seen him. We have not seen Mallara. How you used to look, how you must be behaving in this situation. But I feel ki yaar, agar ye sab characteristics hai unke, so maybe if something I'm connecting with him through my soul, I'll be able to get it. If I'm talking to you, somewhere I know we are connected somewhere, I don't know how. So many people all over the world, only you could, you know, we could have such a great interaction for so long. Somewhere, yeah. Some connection we have to find. It's such a beautiful thing. As a human being, we are so blessed to understand our conscience. We are not understanding our soul. We are understanding all the other factors of life. We are trying to get into the other materialistic things. People are getting fast-paced. They don't know what they have lived for. As a human being, if you start loving your own internal body, you don't have to go outside anymore. If you start loving, people will start loving you. You will start loving them. It's a beautiful world. And this the negativity, the energy, bad energy, bad vibes will all fade away.
Right.
So it's very far-fetched because people are not getting internal. People are all external. People just want to show themselves how they are. And, you know, it's all something.
I think people should we should all learn to have some patience. It's a very fast-forward world now. Everyone is lacking patience.
Hold your horses. Just slow down.
Yes.
This is just to wait for the right time and wait for the opportunity.
Right.
Stop. Could come to you someday or the other.
Right.
Be prepared. Chance always favors the prepared mind.
Yes, true.
Have a blind eye to a deaf ear, blind eye. All these organs, if we keep it intact and we just value this full Almighty has given us, such beautiful place to live. Enough of, let's talk something else. You said something about your Krishna connect and all. Tell me about that. So you kept your son's name also as Krish.
Yes.
Because you thought when he was in your womb, you
it's
thought,
actually,
you know,
the connect goes back even longer. So when I was in my mother's womb, you know, so when my mother was expecting me, so and I'm the second child. So a lot of people, they were hoping and expecting.
I'm also my mother's second child.
Oh, really? Oh, nice. So we have a lot of similarities. So my elder sister, so I have an elder sister, I'm the second one. And mom was expecting me. So everyone was hoping that the pehli wali ladki hai, to beta hona chahiye. So everyone was expecting me.
Tell me this.
Yes.
My elder brother, of course, he's elder brother, he was. So when I was in the room, they all thought, oh,
well, you girl.
I think we are interchanged.
So when my mother was expecting me, so she consulted her astrologer, said ki ladka hogi ya ladki. So the astrologer told her ki ladki hogi aur Krishna bhakt hogi. So she said okay, and it was true because I was of course born. And yes, what happened was I had some mom had some complications. I was because my survival was literally questioned, you know? So I wasn't supposed to survive, but I did, and I did, of course, because I'm sitting here. So you know, so what happened was yes, when I started growing up and I was still very young, I had he's my friend. I start close to me, I can talk to him and he'll tell me secrets and I can tell him secrets. So it was like that. So over the years passed, and I had a child when I was hoping that I should have a daughter because then I can dress her up very sweetly and cutely and all. I came to know that I'm carrying a son. So here in US they tell you the, you know, the gender of the child, and I came to know that I'm carrying a son. Day is was Janmashtami, and the moment I came to know, I saw the result and I had tears in my eyes, because all along my childhood and my growing years, I used to think, or I used to report that when I have a baby, it's like Krishna coming to me. So when it happened, then I realized that, you know my little prayers as a child, and he heard. So then I said he is Krishna. So that's what
we decided. What a great experience. Some bodily thing is there at your place. Something is there. Some divine soul is there. Yeah.
I hold the thought close to my heart.
Superb. It is a lovely experience. I just love the way you did that all experience. It's so sweet. That divinity is there. I can see that. Hear your son's picture to me on my WhatsApp.
I will. I absolutely will. And if we are in India, next time if we are in Bombay, I'll definitely visit you.
You have to visit my place. Whenever you plan, let me know in advance.
Yes, so, and whenever you visit US, I'm going to ensure you do, because I'm working towards it. I'm hoping to get you some good projects there.
Keep me in your prayers.
Absolutely, you are. You don't have to say that. You have always been, ever since we interacted the first time, have been.
Lovely talking to you, Ravani. God bless you.
I really like and love talking to you.
You take care.
You take care too. Please take care. My regards to your family and all of you. Take care.